All the issues were discussed. What are the problems being faced by the cricketers? What is the problems being faced by us to implement it also? And it was a very good, vibrant discussion we had. No tutu memes and all that. And Saurabh was also there on Skype and putting his this thing. And it was good suggestions did come in. And also that we will now formulate a paper and put it to the amicus to put it up to the court. But as of now, the conflict of interest rules have to be followed because they are enshrined in the constitution. And as and when it will be decided by the court, the amendments will be made.
Ma'am, has the discussion over or there will be another round of the...
Let's see how it goes. We COA will, because our chairman was not here today, we will sit in our next meeting and discuss all these points. A white paper will be made and... we are trying our level best to see what is best for cricket. We don't want to hamper anybody also, but stay within the rules also. And if the Supreme Court decides as and when, the amendments will be down the line for everybody and it will be a good sign for cricket.
And there were also reports that henceforth, whatever the conflict of interest comes, the BCCI will also react to it. Like instead of
we have been reacting to it. Our opinions, our report, the ethics officer sends the complaint to us.
Yeah.
We give our views also, and this thing, and then he takes the call. As of today, he is still going to take the call. We have to respect that. He's a former judge of the Supreme Court, and he's definitely going to go by the rule book. And yes, it's there that cricket is having a little problem with this conflict rules. But we will hopefully, and I think so, if the paper is put up properly to the court will definitely understand.